Hello, good afternoon, everyone. So today I'm going to talk about the research I'm doing in the lab. So my research is about the quantum dots, and we're using this quantum dot to make solar cells. So solar cells, we're going to make them highly efficient. So the basic motivation in doing this is that the sun has a huge range of solar radiation. So in order to capture that, we need an active material, so those are called quantum dots. So our quantum dots are able to absorb a huge range of those radiation, so we are hoping that the efficiency of our solar cell will definitely increase. So in order to synthesize those quantum dots, so we use the method that's combined of sonication and heating, so that can be seen in this part of the slide. So we start with bulk material, we sonicate that. Sonicate means we caught that using the sound wave, and then we heat them. So after we make them, we make the quantum dots, so we have to purify them and see under UV radiation whether we have formed the quantum dot or not. So this picture shows that whenever we heat those quantum dots with UV radiation, we get the blue fluorescence. So that is the proof that we made those quantum dots. And then on those two plots, so we have our boron nitride and then vermolytum disulfide quantum dot. So we are able to absorb the radiation from 350 to 550. So that's a big range of solar spectrum. So these particles are further characterized with TEM and TEM images. So we can see that these are of nanometer size. So after making these things, so we have to construct a solar cell, and the outline for a solar cell is here. So we start with glass, and then on the top of the glass we grow ICO nanowires, and then we have a zinc oxide layer. So zinc oxide layer will collect the electron. So MOS2 is an active layer where the electron hole pairs are created whenever it is hit by a solar radiation. And we have the molybdenum oxide layer, so that is the hole injection layer. And the AO is the electrode. So we have a active current flowing through this device, and solar cell would be operating. So the next one is the energy band diagram. So this energy band diagram shows that so electron would flow from molybdenum disulfide to zinc oxide and to ICO, and then the hole. So this white part is the hole, and it would go from valence band to the gold electrode. So we have successfully synthesized the quantum dot, and we are in the process of making the solar cell. Thank you very much.